Good day, everyone. It's Kyle here with our Bitcoin price action update, and Bitcoin is still attempting to work on a bounce. In yesterday's analysis, we were paying close attention right in this area here. I'll just go ahead and give that a quick circle right in there as we saw the 10 starting to get through the 200 EMA as well as the white 200 simple moving average here. I'll zoom in a little bit closer here. And we see that yesterday's candle was reaching for that 200 there. A little bit of a rejection there, nothing major. Still a beautiful candle getting engulfing this previous candle before it. And then, of course, testing that 10 again today. And so far, price action is getting squished down below the zero spot 236. So, you know, these moving averages, they can serve as support. Once they're lost, they can act as resistance. And we're seeing that play out a little bit right now, but no heavy selling stepping in just yet. Down below on the RSI, we see the RSI still grinding its way to the upside here. And I pretty much consider this a test of the EMA right now. And we can see that this test is beginning to flatten it out. But both are still in the bearish control zone here. So still certainly a lot of pressure being implied. But what we want to look for is we want to see that RSI get above that EMA and eventually get spat out of the bearish control zone. And then we could look for some continuation. So this bounce could become a relief rally at some point if this keeps up. Dropping down to the stochastics. So stochastics are still technically up, but we're not seeing a ton of follow through yet just on the price action just yet. But it's still encouraging that they are signaling that there's some pressure still present here to the upside. And down below in the MACD, we see the MACD certainly losing a lot of its negative momentum here, getting another lighter colored bar on the histogram here. And we're starting to see the fast line actually cross back to the upside. So we are seeing some signs that the sellers are running out of ammunition here and that this bounce could potentially become a relief rally. Let's jump into the 4 hour here because we were looking at that yesterday. So the 4 hour is... it's showing some signs of life now. We've seen this really obvious clear downtrend here. Pretty nasty stuff. But recently, we do see a pivot point getting stuck in right here. So we've gotten a higher high than this pivot point here for the first time in this whole gross-ass downtrend here. So that's encouraging. So now the next thing we're going to look for here, it's going to get rid of my beautiful green circles if TradingView will let me do that without deleting my moving averages. Thanks, TradingView. How generous of you. So we see that this bounce has come in, and another thing that we're seeing a change of behavior in the short-term time frame is that we're seeing price action attempting to get above not only the 10, 21, and 30 now, multiple four-hour closures here, multiple back tests, and as of right now, this four-hour candle is trying to find support off the 10, 21, and 30. So we might see that 10 and 21 cross through the 30, and that overall is a good look. I mean, if you look back here, when we started to see these crosses happen in this area, well, what happened? It was just disgusting downtrend. And I'm not suggesting that we're going to see this massive V-bottom recovery if that happens, but we are starting to see the etchings of a change of behavior. And perhaps, you know, perhaps if, you know, we've got the higher high, if we can get a higher low now in price action, perhaps we see some of this gross downtrend undone. And then, of course, our targets remain the same. We're going to be watching ultimately the zero spot 382 coming in around 43,517. Of course, we have that 55 to contend with, but over time likely we'll break through that, and then we look to that very key Fibonacci levels. Drop down the RSI. The RSI is looking a little bit more constructive here as we see it get out of the bearish control zone, and we're seeing the exponential moving average also get out of the bearish control zone. And look at that, the RSI is coming down and finding support off it. So this is a pretty good look on the RSI, you know, to go alongside the price action here. So that's overall looking encouraging. We do see the stochastics cross to the downside here, so we'll have to pay attention to that. But if we're going to get a 4 hour uptrend here in the next coming days, then, you know, I won't be putting a heck of a lot of weight on that, as, you know, stochastics can pretty much just swerve around in that area when there's a trend in progress. Dropping down on the MACD, we see the positive momentum beginning to wane here, but the moving averages are fast approaching the zero read of the y-axis, and both angled very nicely to the upside. So we are starting to see some glimmers of hope here on the 4 hour, and certainly this could end up spilling into the higher time frames over time. But the first thing we want to see is, now that we've gotten a higher high as opposed to this pivot point back here, so that's the last lower high before the final dump to the downside here, and now we see a high coming in taking that out. So now we're on the higher low watch, and anything above this pivot point here is technically going to be a higher low. So overall, that's looking quite encouraging. Let's see if we can get that, and if we do, likely to spill into that daily time frame. And of course, we're going to watch that zero spot 382. Again, we're going to have to push past some of these moving averages. As you can see, they are still harassing price action right now. But that 4 hour is starting to give us a little sign of hope here. Anyways, thanks so much for coming by and checking out this video, everyone. Hopefully you found that helpful. Again, I'll be bringing these updates more frequently on Bitcoin. As we know, when Bitcoin decides to do crazy things, it certainly disrupts the alt sector. Anyway, looking forward to seeing the next one. And until I do, have yourselves a powerful day.